Hi Taurus, and welcome to your monthly tarot reading. This is a general reading that could benefit any sun, moon, or rising sign of Taurus. And we'll get a sense of what the energies or messages are for the month, and we can plan accordingly. And we'll pull some oracle cards afterwards for further guidance and clarity. What can we learn from Taurus? Okay. Okay, give me a moment to take a look at your cards here. Very interesting. We have a little bit of everything happening here. So let's begin with the Knight of Cups. So we see this Knight of Cups, and he is approaching with a cup in hand. The horse looks very under control. So this is energy, or could represent a person within your circle. That's how we look at court cards. And this type of energy, this is a sensitive person, someone perhaps a dreamer, a romantic. If you are meeting someone and dating someone and you encounter a Knight of Cups kind of person, they have good manners. They are very respectful, very tender-hearted, would probably be giving you some poetry or some poems, would be reading you poems, but there's a very much sense of a sensitive soul. You know, knights go out for adventure, they have quests, and this romantic notion. So this is, you know, this is a very loving and kind of caring knight. And this cup, this could, you know, represent getting a message or an opportunity, and maybe it's simply an opportunity where you're going to be meeting someone like this. A lot of healing attributes with these cups, very sensitive and emotional. The flip side could be maybe a little moody or a little too dreamy and not enough feet on the ground type of energy. So that's just something to think about. But this could be, you know, it could be something that you would benefit from, this energy, or someone that you're going to encounter. And then we have the Ten of Cups. And this Ten of Cups, you can see the couple with the children are raising their hands in awe of the cups and the rainbow. And this is a card about really reaching the rainbow and securing the rainbow dream of a family and of community and the love from children and abundance and, you know, just having success at home. So this is, if you are in a relationship, this bodes well that you may be making it more permanent, and maybe you're going to be getting engaged or married or moving in. If you're single, it should give you hope, perhaps, that you keep your eyes open and get yourself out there and mingle. You might meet someone that could result in this, the dream of having it all, you know, having abundance and having love and all of those things, family and success that you are grateful for and showing abundance for. So, you know, this is could be related to our Knight of Cups. He could be the man, if you're single, or, you know, the female equivalent, coming in to make your life complete and whole. And that sense of wholeness continues when we see the world. And the world is the last card in the major arcana, and it's really the card of completion, the card of feeling whole, the card of happiness and joy. You can see the woman here. She's either skipping or dancing. She's within this victory wreath, wearing her purple sash, and that purple reflects intuition and psychic ability. And so, you know, she's got her wands pointing above and below. And this is really a card about reaching your goals, of reaching the end of what you've hoped to achieve. And it's a card of achievement and of really, you know, the world is in your hands. You know, you've, congratulations, you've made it. Now, this is, you don't stop here. When you reach the things that are going to make you whole, you've got to keep thinking about what next. Where do I go from here? You know, what's the next path that I'm going to take? So on your path, you know, you're moving right along to whatever is coming up next. We have the Chariot. And the Chariot has been really showing up in other signs readings as well. And so this is movement, and this is control and mastery of where you're headed. And you're in the driver's seat, and you have the skills to take yourself to completion, to take yourself through to the end, to find your happy ending, your happy life with family. And this is, you can see there's a black and white sphinx that is powering the Chariot. And this is really about navigating the oppositional forces. So, you know, we always have things kind of lined up against each other. So, you know, you are skillfully maneuvering through those things, maintaining the balance, maintaining the control. This card also suggests a lot of confidence for you that this is your time. And, you know, regardless of whatever things may pop up for you that might try to block you or might be an obstacle, you're going to be able to get around it. You're going to be able to drive through it and to get your recognition. And, you know, this is thought of as the winning card, as the victory card in the major arcana. So you will be able to be successful, to reach your goals, to feel complete, to have it all perhaps, using your ability to control and to navigate. And this is a very powerful card in helping you manifest and get to the completion, into the you know, your world, of making your world what it is. Along the way, you're going to have some Queen of Cups energy, which is wonderful, delightful energy. Now, again, it could be energy that you can take advantage of, or it could be, a water sign that you're going to encounter. Maybe an older feminine person, a woman who has a lot of these attributes, and this is a queen who is very sensitive, who is very much used to using her intuition and trusting her instinct. She's fair. She's compassionate. If you have something to run by, meaning some, if you need advice, she's someone who would give you great advice, honest advice, in a very gentle way, perhaps. Is able to understand and to empathize with others. So she'll be able to understand where you're coming from with whatever it may be. And she's successful. She's a master of her element, which is cups, which is handling emotions. And this is just the right balance of emotions, of listening and having a good heart. You know, this is a nurturing type of queen. And we have another nurturing queen within here as well. So this is, I think, very positive. This is, opportunity for you to listen to your intuition, to trust your instinct, and to get in touch with your emotions, to have positive emotional experiences. Work is showing up, and this work is about doing a great job. This is the Eight of Pentacles, and you can see that this apprentice here is working very hard without distraction and is hammering away at the pentacles and is very proud of his work and is displaying it. So this is a card where you are working hard, you're doing a super job, this is skilled work, and so maybe you're in programming, maybe you're making jewelry or doing something that requires some precision. And this Eight of Pentacles, you're doing it without distraction, so you are 100% focused. And you can see there's a little town in the background, but you know he's not looking at the town, he's looking on doing the best job that he can do. So therefore, you will be doing the best job that you can do and giving it your all. And you know, this is work that you find fulfilling. And this is work that you find satisfying. It's not tedious at all. You know, if it was in reverse, it may be tedious, but for now, it's something that you really enjoy doing. With this Eight of Pentacles, you also might have an opportunity to learn from someone more skilled. You may be able to increase your knowledge base or to improve upon what you do for a living. This card suggests that while you may not be making a lot of financial reward right now, you will in the future, and perhaps you're doing pretty good now. But this is a sense that if you continue along this path of working hard, of being dedicated, and being skilled in your craft, that you will ultimately gain security and financial success and recognition as well. So, rounding out towards the end, see this Queen of Pentacles. And the Queen of Pentacles, she's sitting there with her big pentacle and with a little rabbit watching her. And this is about the Queen is the master of her suit. And her suit is Pentacles, which is about practical, grounded energy with respect to life approach, with respect to finances, with respect to work. It's really the Queen is someone who can do it all. She can manage her household, she can manage a business, she is resourceful, she likes to live well, so if she's working hard, she enjoys spending and having some comforts, and is not shy about keeping those out or keeping those hidden. She's going to enjoy the fruits of her labor. The Queen of Pentacles is someone that, if you called and said, hey, I need some help on this matter, can you come over and talk to me? That this is the type of person that would drop everything and come and talk to you. There's a sense of dependability, of reliability, of someone who is loving and caring, and that, if the Queen of Pentacles found out that you were sick, that she would bring you chicken noodle soup to make you feel better. So whether this is someone in your life, a sister, a mother, a wife, a grandmother, you know, this is very positive energy that really takes hold of pragmatic and grounded approaches, and you know that helps you in terms of money, that helps you in terms of your career. With this Queen, there's also a sense of really enjoying nature. You know, she is of the earth, and so you know, listen to the Queen and take some time out to get outside, take some time to have some fresh air, to get some rays from the sun, or to be around beautiful trees or flowers or animals. So it's always a gentle reminder from the Queen of Pentacles to appreciate nature and all of its abundance. And then along with the working hard and being skilled, you are going to feel perhaps you're working a little too hard in. This is the Ten of Wands, and you can see this guy is pushing these wands up the street. He's going to reach his goal. He's going to get the job done. He's got his head down. He's focused. He's strong. And so he's able to make it happen. But really, the real question here is, why doing it alone? You know, why are you shouldering all of the work yourself? This is a time, perhaps, that you can delegate. If you have too many obligations, if you have too many responsibilities, if you've got too much going on, that if you can find a way to delegate, if you can ask people to do their fair part, to please chip in. You know, I can't make this happen by myself. I need your help. And this could help it happen in a couple scenarios. It could be in the home front. It could be you're so busy running the household and taking care of kids and trying to work that you just feel overworked, tired, and you feel burdened. And this could happen in the office as well, that you're doing a super job and people keep wanting to give you projects. And you're like, yeah, sure, I can do that. No problem. Maybe you're afraid to say no. Okay, I can do it. And then it just becomes too much. And what happens is then you begin to resent it, or you begin to feel anxious or feel stressed out. And that affects your health. So to the degree possible, try to have honest conversations with people saying, I need some help here. I need you to help me get this finished. You know, if you're decluttering the garage or if you're building something and you need your kids to help you, you know, ask them. Say, hey, get off the Xbox and come and help me. So this is a card of working very hard and feeling that you're burdened, feeling that you're a little overwhelmed. And so it's going to be up to you to take some steps and some action to not let that happen. Let me just take a moment here to see if there's anything else that I've missed. I mean, but there's a sense of wholeness, of completion, of driving towards this wholeness, of possibilities, of the great happy story, the storybook ending, someone's sensitive potential date, perhaps dear friend, some emotional experience with the Knight of Cups, someone who is very charming and sweet and generous and kind. You've got some work in here, you've got overburdened, and then you've got some queens coming in to assist as well. And the queens each bring different attributes, which is emotional sense, loving, intuition, and then the practical approach to balance it out. So let's take a look at an oracle card about love for you. Let's get a sense of what is happening for you in for love. Okay, come out. Tolerance. You appreciate other points of view because you sense the love in everyone. Tolerance goes a long way. It's always nice to see people show and demonstrate tolerance and to be tolerant of others and to be accepting of others. You know, it shows great maturity. It shows great openness to receive. And not everyone's the same. We're not all cookie cutter type of folks. We all have different experiences. We all have different challenges. We all want perhaps the same thing, though, which is love. And to show unconditional love, you know, you have to be tolerant. You have to be accepting. You have to be open. And you've got to look for the good in others. You've got to see through whatever veneer they may put up and cut them some slack, give them a break. So tolerance is a beautiful focus for love in life, which is, be open, be aware of other people are, different from you and I. Finally, I would like to pull a card, an abundance card from Dorian Virtue. These are relatively new. I think they came out in the spring. And let's just get a focus for the month in terms of abundance and things to work on. This is block out distractions. Your life purpose and other priorities need your undivided attention, so it's time for you to take charge of your schedule and working environment by, this is turning off the computers, turning off the games, turning off the cell phones, and just kind of disconnecting. Blocking out distractions, and maybe that requires that you go to a quiet place and meditate, or you need to go for a walk around the block, and you can leave your phone at home. But this is going to, when you're able to block out these distractions, you're a lot like the apprentice here in the Eight of Pentacles. You get great results. And there's also a sense of freedom. When you're able to disconnect from electronics and things and Facebook and all the social media, there's a sense of freedom. And, it's way before those things were ever in existence. People did just fine. People survived just fine. Let's see. You already know what these distractions are and you have the power to responsibly block them out. Everybody knows what is their weakness when it comes to distractions. So it's up to you to find a way to maybe chip away at the time spent that is maybe not productive or things that are holding you back. A little bit goes a long way. So I think that you have a really nice month of where you're going to have the opportunity to feel whole and to feel complete and to have some good practical queen energy. I wish you the very best. And if you enjoyed this reading, please like, share, or comment. I really do enjoy responding to comments. And if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. It's a great way to show support and to stay connected. And I hope I will see you again for future readings. Thanks so much and take care. Bye-bye.